The tabletop exercise held at Mika Eco Resort Hotel in Hoima started on Tuesday with a guided tour in the Kingfisher Development Area at Buhuka Landing Site in Chukwube District. The area is being developed by China offshore oil company Sinok Uganda Limited. The purpose of the exercise was to give the stakeholders a better understanding on oil spill safety preparedness, as well as discuss roles, responsibilities and cooperation between agencies that will be involved in case of an oil spill at Lake Albert.
All the major stakeholders that are involved in oil spill contingency management plans, like the ministries, the joint venture partners, the agencies and the local governments, and of course the media, to get together and familiarize themselves on situations, what role they will play in case we have an oil spill.
Exercise, we will share knowledge and experience between the different institutions, both on national level and local level, and also from the oil company.
Isaac Ntuju, the principal environment inspector at the National Environment Management Authority, explained the impacts of oil spills both on land and in Lake Albert water.
There are some known impacts. For instance, there can be impacts to wildlife. There can be impacts to the livelihoods if, for instance, it affects communities and businesses. So an oil spill will affect such a business. It can affect ecosystems, because the species that exist in the environment do not live on their own. Every species, there's interdependence of species, and that forms part of the ecosystem that they rely on. So because of that, ecosystems can be compromised and damaged when an oil spill happens.
Ntuju also explained the classes of tires that have been established under the National Oil Spill Contingency Plan.
Tier 1 is an oil spill that is ideally within the confines and the ability of the oil company. If it is within their premises, and they can manage to respond to it very well, that is a tier one. But sometimes you find that things happen and then the oil spreads into communities. Oil companies have no business in communities. They have an obligation to prevent harm to communities, but if the issues are happening in the community, then they need to work with the district local government.
Samuel Magambo, the chairperson disaster management committee in the district, is concerned about the increasing number of settlements near well pads in Kingfisher oil field at Buhuka landing site, escalated by speculations on compensations.
In case of any emergencies, especially that which require interventions like resettling people and providing livelihood support, we collectively engage them and have the situation arrested or managed.
Using imagination scenarios, the exercise discussed the notifications, roles and response activations, among others.
We built flows containing the oil within that damaged pipeline section with some material. And they can use glue depending on what material is available. You could also bring excavation material. You come and dump onto where the leakage is coming from.
If the crew of Kingfisher reached the lake, like in part 4, where the modeling showed, it is very easy for us to put a boom, and this crew will not be able to move to Congo, move to the next Kaiso village. We'll be able to
Lawrence Chiarimpa, the Warden of Environmental Impact Assessment at Uganda Wildlife Authority, and Samuel Kahesi, who represented the local government, also explained their response measures.
Activate OAR to come and rescue wildlife, especially the birds on the shoreline.
We move together, we work together, and let us build the pressure.
Uganda hopes to produce its first oil in the first quarter of 2025. This report was compiled by Ambrose Nwagabakatoto for the news.